There have been some aerial dogfights off the East Coast over the past few months involving some crack Navy pilots and mock Soviet jets, and computers, not live ammunition, have determined the winners. Military specialist Chuck DeCaro explains.
The arena of modern air-to-air combat, high altitude, supersonic speed, and lethal weapons. Fights that are won or lost in milliseconds. In this exclusive report, CNN is the first to fly with an elite U.S. Navy squadron that uses Soviet-style tactics and aircraft to sharpen the skills of other U.S. aviators. Here in simulated combat, we engage a Navy F-14 Tomcat. The 50,000-pound jet will pass only 300 feet away at a closing speed of 1,600 miles an hour. As he passes to the left, we are buffeted by his supersonic wake. Here again in slow motion, the $30 million F-14, moving past at half a mile per second, illustrating the fleeting nature of a modern dogfight. This is the threat, the tactical air forces of the Soviet bloc, some 7,500 high-performance jets. They outnumber NATO fighters by at least 2.5 to 1, and according to defense sources, the Soviet aircraft are improving in sophistication and growing even larger in numbers, making the numerical odds even worse.
The Navy contends that it can even those odds by using a pair of special jet fighter units called adversary squadrons. This one, BF-43 in Norfolk, Virginia, employs a combination of small, simple, agile jet fighters and Soviet tactics in order to train other naval attack and fighter units.
The adversary concept started in the late 1960s as a fallout from our lack of success in the air-to-air arena in Vietnam. There was a need to be able to train our air crews in simulated threat aircraft and how to improve their kill ratio.
Lieutenant Commander John Stuffelbeam, whose call sign is Boomer, is the operations officer for the adversary squadron BF-43. He and his colleagues fly 3 and sometimes 4 simulated dogfights every day using Soviet tactics.
You go to work day to day as a Russian pilot, and you're trained to think like a Russian pilot. Could you tell me what that's like?
Well, he's very confident in what he does. He's very well trained. I don't think he's as well trained as the American pilot is. He's getting very good equipment now, so where he has been lacking before in equipment, that's now being made up. So if you combine his knowledge with more capable equipment now, he's become an extremely serious adversary threat.
Simulating Soviet jets with several types of aircraft, including these recently arrived Israeli-manufactured Kafir fighters, the adversary squadron teaches a 3-week air combat course, gradually increasing the threat from a one-on-one dogfight to a swirling air battle involving many aircraft. The precise outcome is determined by a sophisticated computer system, which simultaneously tracks all the aircraft and determines who won and who lost. This reporter flew with Lieutenant Commander Rick McPhee, call sign Bear, in a T-38 supersonic trainer in a realistic scenario involving 4 adversary jets against 2 F-14 Tomcat fighters. We start engines and taxi out, past our opposition. A pair of $30 million F-14s, big, sophisticated, and deadly. Accelerating rapidly down the runway, we start our takeoff and head for the practice area, just off the Virginia coast. And we are joined by F-5s and an A-4. Initially, we fly tight formation and discuss our war plan.
Trying to pick the direction which would be easiest to hide ourselves in. Here we got a low sun. Out to the east, a big reflection off the water, which tends to highlight a bogey when you're flying from that direction.
GCI, or Ground Controlled Intercept, radios us and gives us radar vectors towards the F-14s.
010 at 10, 010 at 10.
A wingman sees the F-14s.
Because they're both together, they're about 2 miles apart. Down to a little combat spread with a guy out to the left side.
Bear spots the F-14s, nearly invisible dots low and to our right, closing very fast. He rolls in to attack.
Okay, we're going to pass the first.
Who's going to take 2?
Go get him. Okay, pass the one now, Mark, Mark.
Bear's gone after the eastern one.
But Bear cannot turn fast enough, and the F-14 zooms by. Neither side can get off a shot. The first dogfight is a draw, and we set up for another attack. Meanwhile, on the ground, the computer is instantaneously tracking all the aircraft. We are number 5, headed directly for the F-14 labeled number 2. As in the first dogfight, we are simulating Soviets, who are dependent on ground radar for attack vectors.
0406 miles.
We are closing at a combined speed of over 1,600 miles an hour, half a mile a second. But the sophisticated F-14, whose cockpit view is here generated by the computer, can identify us with his automatic long-range television camera before we can see him with our eyes. He locks on with a simulated all-aspect Sidewinder heat-seeking missile. As Soviets, we must maneuver behind in order to use our heat-seeking missiles. As we see him, it's too late. On the ground, the computer confirms the kill, wrapping our symbol in an electronic coffin. Minutes later, we re-establish our formation and head back to base, where all the aviators will watch the computer generation and learn all the lessons of the day's aerial combat. With Navy Adversary Squadron VF-43 over Oceana, Virginia, this is Chuck DeCaro, CNN, on special assignment.
That's it for this weekend edition of Special Assignment. If you have a suggestion for a story, write us in care of Special Assignment, 2133 Wisconsin Avenue, Northwest, Washington, D.C., 20007. From Atlanta, I'm Larry Woods.